Starfish Dissection. After completing this video, you should be able to 1. Name the organs of the starfish, 2. Identify the features that serve as adaptations for starfish, and 3. Describe the correct procedure for dissecting a starfish. Starfish are currently facing a number of natural and man-made threats that are decreasing their numbers. For this lab, instead of each student dissecting a starfish, you'll watch this video dissection. You'll then use this information to answer your lab questions. Starfish, or sea stars, are radially symmetric marine invertebrates in the phylum Echinodermata. These organisms display the deuterostrum pattern of development and are ecologically crucial keystone species. The starfish has a spiny surface known as the endoskeleton, a hard structure composed of calcium-rich plates. The protruding white spines actually project through a thin layer of epidural skin that covers the endoskeleton. The body of the starfish has an aboral, or top side, and an oral, or bottom side. The central disc and madreporite are found on the surface of the aboral side. The mouth can be found on the oral side. It can be seen in the middle of the central disc and will be surrounded by spines. Notice the ambulacral grooves that extend from the mouth to the tip of each arm. Observe the suction cup-like projections known as tube feet, which line these grooves. Proceeding one arm at a time, the tips of the arms are cut off and the sides of the arm are cut toward the central disc. The cuts are made as close to the skin as possible. Notice that the skin is lifted as it is cut, and the point of the scissors is used. This allows for the removal of the flap or aboral surface tissue. The flap is cut away to reveal the internal organs. This is repeated for the other two arms. Next, the central disc is removed, and care is taken not to remove or damage the madreporite. The cuts are just to the inside of the madreporite. At this point, most of the aboral surface is removed from the body. In one of the arms, observe the pyloric cecum, which is seen as brown material just under the skin. These are digestive glands that secrete enzymes that break down food and store nutrients. When the pyloric cecum is removed, it exposes the gonads. These structures are involved in sexual reproduction and appear to be clustered and arranged like grapes. In another arm, both the pyloric cecum and the gonads are removed. Observe the ampullae of the tube feet, which line the ambulacral ridge. These appear jelly-like, or like small bulbs which connect with a podium of the tube feet. Water enters the porous plate structure known as the madreporite. Observe the stone canal, a small tube that extends from the madreporite and leads to a series of canals, first of which is the ring canal. Identify the ring canal which runs around the central disc. Next, observe how the radial canals extend from the ring canal. The radial canals are located under the ambulacral ridge. The radial canals feed into the ampullae, which are connected to the tube feet. The path of water through the madreporite, stone canal, radial canal, ampullae, and tube feet can be easily traced. This system of ducts is referred to as the water vascular system and allows for the starfish to move and feed. Water from the radial canal fills the ampullae. When ampullae are squeezed, they push water into the tube feet, which are directly connected to the ampullae. The water vascular system expands or contracts tube feet and acts as a hydrostatic skeleton. In conclusion, echinoderms have several unique features. The water vascular system consists of a series of canals carrying water, helping the organism with locomotion and feeding. Most adult echinoderms, unlike other deuterostrums, don't display bilateral symmetry but are radially symmetric. One of the structural features tying the echinoderms with the deuterostrums, like the chordates, is the endoskeleton.